Hello and welcome to another edition of This Week in Jewish History. Today we'll be talking about a date that's very important in the Chabad Hasidic calendar, Yud Shvat, which corresponds to January 17th of 1951, which marks the first anniversary of the death of the sixth Rebbe, and more significantly for his followers, the ascendance to the leadership of the Chabad movement by Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson, shown here in this image. Over the course of several decades of leadership, Rabbi Schneerson was undoubtedly one of the most influential rabbis of the 20th century, if not the modern period as a whole, and although his career was not without controversy, there is no doubt that he left a lasting impact on the Jewish world and, in fact, the general world as a whole. So let's have a look at the controversy surrounding his rise to the head of that movement. The succession crisis was created because the sixth Rebbe, shown here, who passed away in 1950 after a period of diminished communication because of several strokes, sixth Rebbe had no sons and did not leave a very clear indication as to who should accept the position after he passed on. But there were two obvious contenders. One was Rabbi Ishmario Guari, shown here, known as the Rashag, the husband of the elder daughter of the three daughters of Rabbi Schneerson, the sixth Rebbe. And the other contender, of course, was Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson. They had the same last name because of a familial connection, but Rabbi Schneerson, shown standing here, was the son-in-law of a younger daughter of the Rayatz, the sixth Rebbe, also known as the Frierdiker or previous Rebbe. After the Rebbe, the sixth Rebbe passed away in 1950, there was a certain degree of internal dissension as to which of the two sons-in-law would accept the position. The elder, in many ways, was a more likely choice. The Rashag was associated with traditional Hasidic and Chabad institutions, such as the Yeshivot, whereas the younger son, Rabbi Menachem Mendel, had more of a complex past. He, for example, had received an advanced education at university. He was involved in elements of Kiruv and publication that were not necessarily the hallmarks of Chabad activities, although, of course, they would rise to tremendous heights under his future leadership. And, in fact, many of the Hasidim at the time were divided as to which of the sons-in-law should take leadership. There's no question, however, there's general agreement that the Ramash, Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson, had a very powerful, charismatic personality, and ultimately, over the course of the year, he was convinced to take the helm. After he assumed leadership, although there was some dissension, there's no question that the Rashag, his rival for the position, actually came over and became very close with the Rebbe and accepted his leadership completely. The formal acceptance of the leadership, the nesiut, the princedom, as it were, of the movement, came in January of 1951, on the anniversary of the death of the sixth Rebbe. Hasidim gathered. Some dramatic moments had occurred earlier where several Hasidim had pledged their allegiance to Rabbi Schneerson. And while gathered in a traditional farbrengen, one of the attendees shouted out, "Let us hear a mimer. Let us hear some Hasidic thought." A mimer is a type of discourse, a formal discourse that is only offered by a Rebbe, and no discourses had been offered since the sixth Rebbe had passed away. So when Rabbi Schneerson agreed to deliver a mimer, this was the formal moment at which he became the leader. The mimer, which has been transcribed and reproduced under the title Basi Lagani, it's actually a title that's used several times in Chabad literature, but this is the most significant one for our purposes. It's actually a rather brilliant discussion of the previous sixth Rebbe's, the significance of the number seven, of which, of course, he was the seventh Rebbe, and encapsulated a very profound philosophical orientation towards helping others that would ultimately be the core concept of his leadership and legacy. I'll give you just one example of one of the passage. It's not taken actually from Basi Lagani, but it was part of the discussion that preceded it. The Rebbe spoke in Yiddish and said, you know, on the occasion of his taking this position, here in America, people like to hear a statement, and use the English word in this context, a kind of a quaint usage there. Something different, preferably alarming. And his statement was, the love of God, the love of the Torah, and the love toward a fellow Jew are all one. And indeed, this concept really informed his phenomenal decision-making towards the expansion of the Chabad movement, which has literally encompassed the globe now with over 4,000 institutions in so many countries. It really encapsulates in many ways this concept that all these three things comprise a single whole. And that's basically the anniversary of Yud Shvat, which is celebrated by Chabad Hasidim and followers worldwide this week. Thank you for listening.